Yeah.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Holy Cross as we celebrate the sacrament of First Holy Communion with our young people. Please join in our opening hymn, number 310 in your Burgundy hymnals, Table of Plenty. Number 310, please stand.
Of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lonely to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and eat without money. Come to drink without price. My feast of gladness will feed your spirit with faith and fullness of life. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. My bread will ever sustain you through days of sorrow and woe. My wine will flow like a sea of gladness to flood the depths of your soul. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Your fields will flower in fullness. Your homes will flourish in peace. For I, the giver of home and harvest, will send my rain on the soil. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our very special Mass, the First Communion of our young people here today. So I hope that you are very, very happy today. This is a very special day for all of us. And for you, of course, receiving Jesus in the most blessed sacrament of the Eucharist. You all look really great today. You're all dressed up, nice shoes, nice pants, nice dresses, beautifully done. And I want you to relax. I want you to enjoy this Mass. I want you to be happy. I don't want you to be nervous. I just want you to enjoy, because God has a special gift for you today, and that's His Son in the sacrament of the Eucharist. It's a very, very difficult mystery that we don't totally understand, but we know it's a very special gift that helps us for eternity. So be aware of God's great love for you. Have a sense of thanksgiving and gratitude in your heart as we come together to celebrate this great day in which God shares His Son with us in this most blessed sacrament. So I want you to take a deep breath and let it out and enjoy this Mass, okay? You may return to your family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Well, we all again welcome all of you to our special 2 o'clock Mass for our first communicants. For all of you who are visitors here at Holy Cross, we welcome you to our parish. We Holy Cross parishioners love to have people come and pray with us and visit our church and be with us in our various activities. So if you are a visitor here, we thank you for being here and celebrating this most holy day for our very special little ones. And as we come together to celebrate this Mass, we ask the Lord for His mercy and His forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through your word reconciles the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Joshua. The Lord said to Joshua, "Today I have removed the reproach of Egypt from you." While the Israelites were encamped at Gilgal on the plains of Jericho, they celebrated the Passover on the evening of the 14th of the month. On the day after the Passover, they ate of the produce of the land in the form of unleavened cakes and parched grain. On that same day after the Passover, on which they ate of the produce of the land, the manna ceased. No longer was there manna for the Israelites, who that year ate of the yield of the land of Canaan. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. And all this is from God, who has reconciled us to himself through Christ and given us the ministry of reconciliation. Namely, God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. So we are ambassadors for Christ, as if God were appealing through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made to be sin who did not know sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I will get up and go to my Father and shall say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. Praise to you, Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. The bread that I will give is my flesh, for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen. I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. These things he said while teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we hear Jesus say he wants to give us his body and blood. He wants to give us himself. And the reason why he wants to give us himself is because he wants to show us how much God loves us. When you receive the Holy Eucharist, boys and girls, you're receiving God himself in a very special way. And God comes to you, that little small piece of bread, to show you he loves you. And he wants to feed you. He wants to love you. He wants to forgive you. He wants you to know that you are not alone. And sometimes we may feel alone. Sometimes we feel isolated from people. But God wants us to know he's always there for us. And this Eucharistic bread that he gives us is a special gift to us. And sometimes we don't understand it. I don't understand it sometimes. I'm holding the host like that in Mass. And realizing I'm holding Jesus Christ in my hand, it's hard for me to understand that. And I'm an old man, you know? But when I receive the Eucharist, I know I'm receiving something very, very special from God. And all I can do is say thank you, God, and praise you, God, for you're giving me something that I cannot totally imagine what it is. I just know it's you. It's you coming to me and feeding me and showing me your love. Now, sometimes people have a hard time believing that Jesus is really, you know, that bread that we show you in the wine. It's very hard because it doesn't look like Jesus. It looks like a piece of bread or some wine, doesn't it? Yeah, I mean, you don't see Jesus. So I want to show you something that a priest gave to me a long time ago. He gave this as a gift to me. And you can see this, right? Can you tell me what you think this is? What does that look like to you? A pen. It looked like a pen to you. A pen? What do you think? Pen? Guys, what do you think? You agree? Okay. All right. Okay, back there. Knee glasses. There you go. Okay, pen? Okay, so he gave this to me, and I thought, well, this is really kind of neat because I have to sign things when I'm a priest and so forth. He says, well, it isn't exactly what you think it is. It looks like a pen, feels like a pen, holds like a pen, but it's not a pen. But you're going to use it because you're a priest, and priests use this all the time. I'm going, well, I know priests use pens all the time. He said, well, it's not a pen. I said, what is it? He says, open it up. And I opened it up, and I'm not a magician, so it's not a magic thing. I opened it up. Can you see that? Do you have any idea what that is? You ever seen anything like that before? Huh? Ever seen that like that before? Look at that. I knew it, what it was, but you, because I'm a priest, I know what this is. You know what this is? This is a holy water sprinkler. And this is what priests do sometimes. They go over people's houses and they bless people and their homes and so forth. So in this is holy water. So when the priest goes over and he blesses people, He'll go like that. Did you feel that? You feel that? Okay, so just to prove to you. So what you see is not necessarily what it is. So when you look at the host that the priest gives to you, you'll see just a host. You'll just see like a little cracker, like a little piece of bread. But it's much more than that. It's Jesus coming to you, body and blood, soul and divinity, because he wants to empower you. He wants to love you. But he doesn't want you to keep that Eucharist for yourself. Do you know that? You know, sometimes when people give us a gift, we say, well, this is mine, not yours, not yours, this is mine, my gift, right? And when we get gifts, sometimes we like to keep our gift, right? But sometimes, what do your parents sometimes tell you to do with your, when you get a gift, let's say for Christmas or birthday, what's one thing we're supposed to do with the things that we have that our parents try to teach us to do? What do they try to teach us? And it's hard to do it. Sometimes it's hard for me to do it. And what is it?
Share.
Isn't that hard for you to do that sometimes? I don't want to share something. They might break it or something, you know? But Jesus is saying, I don't want you to keep the Eucharist. I want you to receive it, and then I want you to share it. And you're going to say, well, how am I going to share it? Do I have to break it apart and give it to somebody else? I said, no. You receive Jesus, and then you be Jesus to other people. You bring Jesus to other people. How do I do that? Being kind, being nice, being obedient to your parents, trying to do what is right and good. That's how you share Jesus. And that's one thing that Jesus wants us to do with the Eucharist. He does not want us to keep it to ourselves, say, it's just me and Jesus, me and Jesus, it's just me and Jesus. No, Jesus, I don't want you to keep me for yourself. I want you to share me with others. So understand that what Jesus is doing, that Jesus wants you to bring him to other people. He wants you to be a Eucharist. He wants you to be Holy Communion to other people by showing goodness to other people. I told you that story, didn't I? A thousand times. One time I was in a bad mood and I was driving my car. I'm sure I told that story before. I was in a bad mood. I was in a car and I was mad driving my car. I was driving angry, which was not safe. And I was driving down Harney Street and I was just grumbling about something. I don't know what it is now. And I was driving and I had to stop at another stoplight. I got every stoplight down Harney Street. And I got to the fourth one, another stoplight. And I was thinking not good thoughts, okay? And so I stopped. I'm sitting there just growling about something. I have no idea what it was. And I just happened to turn over and I looked over to the side. There's another car over there. And there was a little kid about your age looking through the window at me. And I never saw that kid before. I don't even know those people over there. I just looked over him, kind of a sour face, looked over him. And he was giving me this big, big smile. And I'll tell you, at that very moment, all my anger went away. I didn't feel bad anymore. That smile just made me feel like, give it up. Don't be such in a bad mood. And I felt so much better because this kid just smiled. So when we just smile or show a little kindness, literally we're sharing the Eucharist with other people. So kind of understand that, boys and girls, and all of us. When we celebrate the Eucharist, it's not for us to keep between us and God. It's for us to share. We are in communion with each other. When we receive the Eucharist, that means we are one, that we are brothers and sisters, that we share the one body and the blood of Christ together. And together we are Christ. Christ is present right here. And he wants us to share him, so the world needs him. We need forgiveness and mercy and forgiveness. And so, and all the things that Jesus brought to this world, it's our responsibility to continue. So congratulations again at your first Holy Communion. Remember, this is a special gift. that you're to share with others. And the more you share Jesus, the more Jesus shares himself with you. Let's now stand. And let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now present our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For the Pope, that he may show Christ's love for sinners and seek out all who may have wandered from the Catholic faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all bishops, priests, deacons, and ministers, that they may faithfully guide us to Jesus, the source of living water, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, that they may work to heal the present quarrels that continue to divide people of many nations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who thirst for meaning and hope in their lives, especially those suffering from broken relationships, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May God fill the hearts of these first communicants, and may they always be as close to the Father as they are today. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people and refugees of Ukraine, that they find a safe place where they can rest their weary bodies and minds, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those personal intentions that we bring here today, and for all those who have died, especially our family members, may they share in the fullness of God's glory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
And for these first communicants for whom this Mass is celebrated, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you share everything with us. We thank you for the gift of the Eucharist. Help us to always reverence it and to receive it often for your glory. We ask you, Lord, to listen to our prayers and answer them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread that we offer you. Through the earth, work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine that we offer you. Through the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, be accepted by you, Lord. May our sacrifice, your sight this day, be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, brethren, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We place before you with joy these offerings, O Lord, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as a fitting offering for the salvation of the whole world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners. He became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt your name as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You're indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loves the human race, who always walks with us on our journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, who is present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when it's once for his disciples, so now for us. He opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, whom you seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant by the power of the Holy Spirit we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, George our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you made your own. Open up our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor in our burden. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and his teachings. And may your church stand as the living witness of mercy and forgiveness, to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone before us in the faith of your Son, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we too may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, the martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now offer one another a sign of peace.
Peace of Christ, everybody. Peace. Peace. And may this from the Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold, Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us in singing number 332, Taste and See. Number 332.
Goodness of the Lord.
Please join me in praying our after communion prayer. You can find a copy of it on the inside cover of your hymnal. I'll give you just a moment to locate it. O good shepherd,
you never cease to seek out the lost, to call home astray, to comfort the frightened, to bind up the wounded. We ask you to bring our missing brothers and sisters back to the practice of the faith, sharing with us the mission of Jesus Christ, and joining us at the Holy Mass and sacraments. Through the intercession of Mary, the Mother of God, and the ever-prayerful Saint Monica, may you free them from whatever hinders their desire to come home. For you, O good Shepherd, have loved us to the end, and offered yourself to the Father for the salvation of all. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who enlightens everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and to love you in all sincerity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Look upon those who called you, O Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death, and bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again, congratulations to our young people who made their first communion today. I also want to thank the families, your parents, your guardians, your godparents, your grandparents, all those who brought Jesus to you before this day. They are your very special people. I always love them and appreciate their love for bringing you to Jesus. That Jesus used them to bring you to us. Always remember now, from now on, when you go to Mass, you can come in line with the rest of the older people and to receive communion with the rest of us, because this is the time that you can now receive Holy Communion. I was just thinking, believe it or not, about 100 years ago, it was not possible. 100 years ago, you had to be 13 years old to receive your first Holy Communion. And the Pope back in the early 1900s changed it so you, at your age, could receive it at the age of 7 and a half. So God bless Pius X, who changed that for you. And again, congratulations to all of you, and thank you for assisting these young people, especially those in our school at Holy Cross, and our religious ed program, our teachers, and those who are involved in the education of our youth. So continue now, boys and girls. This is not a one-time thing. This is your first step in receiving communion. Now continue to receive communion every week so that God can continue to make you strong in his love. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May all the peace, the power, and the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in our closing hymn, number 549, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee, number 549.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks. Thy rays, stars and angels sing around thee, candor of unknown.
sweetheart. Good to see you. What's going on? You doing?